This must be the wreck of the Peacemaker. Some of her cargo may remain.
The thought of death fog gives you pause. A weapon like that should give everyone pause.
Ah, death fog. Instant victory. I always applauded Lucian for using it. A weapon of untold destruction, and you use this against your own kind, knowing it ends their existence? How efficient.
Who wakes up in the morning and thinks, today I'll invent something that'll be able to murder people by the hundreds?
Before you. It looks into your eyes and reaches out a hand of smoke and gossamer, silently begging you to take it. You feel the boards creak under your boots. The smell of salt and pitch fills your nose. You check the knots securing your cargo, hands moving over rough rope in the darkness. There's a shout from above decks, and then the world turns upside down. You're pitched violently sideways as the planks around you rip apart and black water floods in. You try to call out, but all you get is a lungful of water. The hold is filling fast, and the torrent quickly carries you away, dashing you against the hull of the ship. As your vision fades to black, you see the walls shudder as the Peacemaker snaps in two. You awake to the flicker of torchlight and the sound of voices.
Here, crack this in open.
With locks like these, there'll be something good inside. You hear the snap of a latch being broken and a long, low whistle.
Get word to Lohar. The Reds are shipping death fog.
Send your fastest runner.
Go!
Help! You splutter weakly, your mouth producing more water than words. Rough hands grab you, rolling you over to stare into the face of a sneering dwarf. Well now, ain't you an unfortunate little flounder? She growls before clamping her hand across your mouth and nose. Sorry, hun, no witnesses allowed. You kick and struggle weakly, desperately trying to catch a breath, but the dwarf's grip is iron. As your vision starts to swim, you see other dwarves moving in the torchlight, hauling your cargo off the ship. You give one last kick and then... darkness. Stepping back from the spirit, the feeling of her panic starts to slowly fade from your mind.
A perfect fit.
wary. The urns will shatter. The bones will rise.
The glowing corpse looks to you. The erratic rising and falling of its sternum is accompanied by melodramatic gurgles.
Come. Come to me.
The creature murmurs a series of noises, vague but not quite unintelligible. Its head leisurely lolls towards you in response.
Freedom! A single touch of the second from left. My freedom and theirs.
The creature is quiet once more, save its constant wheeze.
Minions, leave me be, parasites!
Shh.